What are the factors determining how long an athlete is asked to be symptom-free before returning to sports?
That's a great question. There's several of them. One is age. I think that's the one that gets the most attention. There's some evidence that younger athletes require a longer time to recover from concussion than older athletes. It's almost the opposite of every other injury in the world. You know, a young kid fractures a bone or sprains a ligament, they recover much more quickly than older patients. But concussion's the opposite way. So certainly we're more conservative with younger athletes. We also don't have as much information. So if you as an athlete playing for an Olympic team, we have tons of information about you. We know your balance before your injury. We know your cognitive function before your injury. We know whether or not you had any symptoms before your injury, such as migraine, headaches, or something else. And so when you're recovered, we're more confident in it. We say, yes, her balance has recovered, her brain function's recovered, her symptoms have resolved. Now we feel really confident that you're better. For a lot of the younger athletes, they don't have that because they don't have the resources. They don't have a team physician or an athletic trainer, and so we're more conservative. Also, how long did it take for you to recover? If your symptoms went away and your brain function returned and your balance returned in a couple of days, it won't make you wait as long to go back to contact as if it took a couple of weeks or a couple of months. Your previous history, if you had other medical conditions or a large number of concussions, we would keep you out of contact for longer. And similarly, how intense were your symptoms? How intense was your brain dysfunction? The worse it is, the longer we keep you out.
Got it.